Please welcome to the stage Mr. William Webster, Executive Director of Civic Concepts International, to present and read the resolution. Please welcome William Webster.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is an honor for me to be addressing you all. Kuala Lumpur Peace Resolution, Global Peace Convention Number 5, December 7th, 2013. Preamble: acknowledging the sovereignty of Almighty God, the source of inalienable rights and the basis for equality, dignity, and intrinsic value of all people, one family under God. Whereas, throughout the ages, religions and faiths have been the source of peace and hope, providing the spiritual resources necessary to build ethical societies, while at the same time, religious rivalries and ethnic conflicts have spread intolerance and violence. Whereas, genuine spiritual leaders of moral authority have served as the catalyst for positive social transformation, championing compassion in action, standing against corruption, fighting racial discrimination, and tirelessly advocating pluralism. Whereas the moral vision of living for the greater good can and must be the basis for inspiring innovative change, and creative collaboration and multi-sector partnerships can bring the necessary collective impact to effectively overcome poverty, inequality, disease, ignorance, illiteracy, and hunger. We, the undersigned, affirm the central importance of universal principles and moral values as the basis for social cohesion in diverse and pluralistic global societies. Affirm the power of traditional extended families to provide the spiritual and ethical education to nurture, transmit the values, moral standards, and culture of service into the next generation. Recognize the unique significance of the Global Peace Convention 5, addressing the theme Unity in Diversity, building social cohesion for sustainable peace through universal aspirations, principles, and values. Convened in Malaysia, a nation committed to the values of unity, tolerance, and moderation. We, therefore, as international delegates of more than 40 nations with diverse cultural traditions, jointly proclaim our resolutions to Amendment 1, Article 1, build a movement of multi-sector, faith-based civil society groups based on the vision of one family under God, rooted in universal principles and shared values, to overcome religious extremism and to promote just and ethical societies. Article 2, promote the establishment of a faith-based peace council as an integral structure of the United Nations, acting as a moral compass for its decision-making bodies, based upon the collective wisdom of the world's great faith traditions. Article 3, promote moral and innovative leadership as a strategic framework for building sustainable peace for a prosperous future. Article 4, invest in youth globally through character and creativity programs in partnerships with ministries of education, advancing moral and innovative leadership. character competency, community building, and social entrepreneurship as essential components, complements to traditional forms of education. Article 5, strengthen the shared vision and networks for promoting volunteerism and service through regional peace, service corps, and community-driven initiatives. Article 6, work collaboratively with the UN, World Bank, governments, the media, the private sector, civil society organizations to promote innovative, community-driven development and youth entrepreneurship initiatives. Article 7, uplift the unique role of women as peace builders and cultivators of universal values in the family through programs that educate and empower women. We hereby commit to support these goals and actions by affixing our signatures. Thank you very much.
We propose this resolution as a statement coming from this convention of our common commitment and ask for unanimous consent by signified by your applause. We have prepared a large representation of this resolution and would like to ask for representatives to sign. I'd like to mention that we will have opportunity for all of you who wish to sign the large resolution to do so at the conclusion of this occasion. But to begin with now in representing our entire group, I'd like to first of all invite up our co-chairs and representatives of our co-chairs, Dr. Hyun Jin Moon and Mrs. Jun Suk Moon, and representatives of our Global Leadership Council. Please come to my left. Those who can join from our Global Leadership Council, Her Excellency, if you could join to sign here on the stage representing our entire group. Coming here to my left.